So welcome back to this second lecture on the series of lectures related to digital prepress. So in this lecture we would be talking about a very important area that is used by everyone in design, in digital prepress for any print job, that is digital font system and digital font management. Now I think you might have a very basic idea on the different what fonts are, because you have already completed the class on typography, where you saw the various anatomy of a typeface and the various characteristics of a typeface, the spacing material, the different family of fonts, the various glyphs that were used. Glyphs, by glyphs I mean the each character, actually a particular character of a from a font family of a particular size, so that is a glyph. So you have a fair bit of idea regarding the movable metal typeface, and you have worked with in the hand composition lab also in the first years. Now, when we are talking about, it's very rare to find out the use of movable metal typefaces nowadays. So we would focus our attention on computer generated font systems or computer based font systems. So when we are talking about computer based font systems, we have to talk about the various classifications. So primarily, if you talk about the different types of font systems that are used today in the computer generated font system market, we'll be seeing there are primarily two types of fonts. One is the bitmap font, and the second is your vector font, or you can say outline font. Now, what is the difference between the bitmap font and outline font? The same difference that you know already regarding the differences between bitmap images or pixel based images and vector based images or object based images. So just like a pixel based image is comprised a number of pixels to create that particular image, similarly bitmap fonts are also consists of a series or a grid of various pixels that represents the image of each glyph of each face and size, meaning for every font family, every glyph of every font family of every size and of every nature. So for example, if you are using a bitmap font of Arial typeface, okay, Arial font, then Arial has various types, that is, it may be bold, it may be underlined, and it may be italics, right? Now similarly, for each of the type of this font, the font size may change. It may be 8, 10, 12, and so on. So similarly for this and this as well. Now, the problem with bitmap font is that for each of the type, that means 8-point bold Arial, 10-point bold Arial, 8-point underlined Arial, 8-point italics Arial. So for each of the character or the glyph, you have a different font. So can you imagine the total number of fonts that would be required for creating a set or a family of Arial type fonts of three different types, there is bold, underline, and italics, of so many font sizes? So it's huge. Essentially, this is a real problem. Also, there is another problem which is related to its scalability. As you know, pixel based images are not scalable. Similarly, bitmap fonts are also not scalable in nature, meaning that since they are made out of a series of or a grid of a fixed size of pixels, the moment you start to enlarge it, so for example you are using 8-point bold faced Arial type font in bitmap format, and you are thinking of enlarging that particular font, the moment you do that, the entire thing will get jagged edges, and it will be pixelated, and it will not give you a very good appearance. So they are not scalable essentially. So also, there are some advantages of bitmap font. I mean, this is the first type of digital font that was created. So obviously, there are some advantages using which which they have, for which they were created. So they were very fast in rendering, because they are not really using any mathematical computational work. They are not taking up much of the memory, working memory of the computer. They are very fast to render. That means they are very fast to be recreated or reproduced in the computer screen digitally. Secondly, they are very easy to create in terms of when I will talk about the different other types, so that is outline font and all of that. Compared to that, they are very easy to create. Now, in case that you are using a specific point of a bitmap font of a particular nature and a font family, you will not face any problem. If your device is supporting this type of a font, let us say your device is supporting the resolution, depending upon the resolution of your device, it is supporting up to 8-point bold Arial format in bitmap without any pixelation. So it is the most easiest thing to use without taking up a lot of computational memory from your computer. Okay, so for all sorts of low quality and small size, older displays and where resolution is limited, for all those type of devices, bitmap fonts works just fine. Okay, so it requires low processing power and memory in the previous time, where elusive, and it was costly to compute a lot of other stuff. So for all those purposes, bitmap fonts were very much used. Even in the earlier dot matrix printers, they used bitmap fonts, because the memory requirements for storing and reproducing bitmap fonts were much less. So for that purpose, that is the advantage of bitmap fonts, given the disadvantages also. Now, as you can very well understand that, you see, there are today memory and computational power is virtually unlimited. I mean, for something as simple as reproducing or carrying out some mathematical computations to reproduce fonts on a screen or a printer, we have more than enough hardware power in our homes or in the palm of our hands, that bitmap fonts doesn't really cut it anymore. So when the computational power started to develop and the bitmap fonts did not really do the work, a different type of font system was created, which came to be known as the outline font or the vector font. Very rarely known as the vector font, mainly they are known as the outline font. Now, I have already mentioned previously that for any vector type art, they are created using certain curves. These curves are known as Bezier curves. So similarly here, the Bezier curves were also used for the creation of these outline or vector based fonts. Now, so obviously, if you are saying that the Bezier curves are used for creation of these outline fonts, you can very well understand that these curves are created using some mathematical equations, by solving some mathematical equations. So as soon as I say that these fonts are made out of some curves, you can already understand that the total amount of processing power required in reproducing outline fonts or Bezier fonts are, vector fonts are higher in comparison to bitmap fonts. But the natural advantage that Bezier curves provide in reproducing art as well as graphics and even fonts is that they are scalable in nature. That means no matter how you go on enlarging that particular font, you go on enlarging it in either your device in your computer displays or your printers, they will not get jagged around the edges, they will not get aliased, and they will not get pixelated. So that is the definite advantage of using outline or vector-based fonts. Now, these type of fonts require, you know, more processing, as I already told you, that depending on the font and rendering, you know, software and output size, all of that, the amount of processing power required is larger. But having said that, the outline fonts can be transformed into bitmap fonts if required. You know, that is possible. But the converse transformation is harder, because you see, the bitmap font they use, they have to almost, you know, they are recreated by a approximation method, by almost, you know, approximation and guessing, and all these things have to be done in order to recreate the bitmap font. But in case of outline font, they are not based on approximations. They are based on simple mathematical equations in order to which are reproduced by reproducing or solving certain mathematical equations and curves. That is why there have been certain problems while conversion from the, you know, the bitmap font to Bezier fonts or outline form or fonts. I hope I have explained it clearly enough. So what I mean to say over here is that you can obviously, you know, convert your outline font into your bitmap font, because of you consider a bitmap font of a particular size and a particular typeface, and you reproduce by switching on the pixels in the site of the or the areas where the Bezier curves have passed. But think about the reverse of it. When you are converting the bitmap font, it is much more difficult to recreate that exact curve which the bitmap font draws, or the path of the bitmap font, because you have to recreate a mathematical equation which your bitmap font has created by approximating some pixels. So hopefully this part is clear. Okay, now you know, although they are scalable and all of this, that is true, but they have another problem as well. I mean, the outline curves, outline fonts, they have a major problem. That is something which is known as hinting, font hinting. What is font hinting? So one of the major problem that lies with outline fonts or vector-based fonts is the fact that they have to undergo what is known as font hinting. Now, font hinting is basically a method through which a outline font or a vector-based font is accommodated within a computer monitor display, so that in such a way, or arrangement of the pixels in such a way that they do not appear to be jagged around the edges. So, in other words, it's basically a mathematical formulation or mathematical instruction that is used to adjust the display of an outline font so that it lines up with the rasterized grid. So take a look at this particular picture. This is what my intention is, right? Now, if it looks fine, the above top line of fonts looks fine, but as soon as the size of the font is changing, we will see some aliasing happening, some jagged edges occurring. Now, why is it happening? It is happening because the Bezier curves that are used for representing these, so this particular C is represented by a Bezier curve, this F is represented by, this line is represented by another Bezier. So this problem occurs when the Bezier curves used for representing the outline font does not fit within the grid of rasterized pixels. So let me try to draw a particular example. Okay, so before going into this, okay, so yeah, so what happens is, suppose this is a particular, one second, just a second, yeah. So let us assume that this is the particular Bezier curve that you are going to reproduce, right? But it has, your pixels are arranged in this format, right? They are arranged in this format. Now, for a particular size of the font, it may so happen that the C that you wanted to draw like this, for a particular size of the font, the pixels in this category, in along this line may not, or the outline that you have drawn, or the Bezier curve that is used for drawing this particular character, may not fall exactly along this line. It may fall along some other pixels, right? Or it may enclose some other pixels, right? So as you go on increasing the size of the font, what will happen? More number of pixels will be used for displaying that font. But the question is, your line, that is the Bezier curve that you are using, may only partially be passing through that pixel. Due to this happening, you see that some pixels are completely lit up. You see, these pixels at the center are completely lit up, but since the Bezier curve is only partially passing through those pixels along the edges, those pixels are partially lit, giving you an appearance of aliasing, giving you an appearance of staircasing effect. So font manufacturers add some additional information that for this particular size, when there is a chance that when the fonts are displayed in this particular size, font size, since there is a chance of staircasing effect or aliasing, they add some additional information, or they embed some additional information with the font file itself, that gives you the information that which primary pixels are to be interpolated or to be used to more clearly render a particular font. So for example, if I previously, during the development of the font, give or add the information to the font family or to the font file, that okay, for this particular size of the pixel, for this particular size of the outline font, you see there is a chance that for a device, the Bezier curve may only partially pass through some pixels. So if the Bezier curve partially passes through that pixels, those pixels, instead of partially lit, instead of partially switching on, those pixels will completely switch on, giving or eliminating the appearance of staircasing effect, eliminating the appearance of this aliasing effect or jagged edges. Okay, so this is what font hinting is. Now, you know that one, as I am talking about font hinting and outline fonts are also of several types, but one particular type of outline font is true type font. Now, true type font, they have additional information related to font hinting, which is known as grid fitting. The grid fitting is nothing but to allow the or ensure that whenever for a particular font size the Bezier curve passes through certain pixels, those pixels will be completely lit up, ensuring that there is no staircasing effect, there is no aliasing effect. This grid fitting technology that True Type Font has ensures that their fonts does not have such artifacts like staircasing effect and jagged edges and all of this. Okay, so not all font makers allow this, add this information. So I will talk about it following this lecture on outline font. But I hope with this you have developed a fair bit of idea on what outline fonts really are, and the advantages and some of the disadvantages of outline fonts also. Now, coming to our next part of the lecture, which is related to the different types of outline font. Now, we first started our lecture regarding the different types of computer or digital fonts, namely the bitmap fonts and the outline or vector fonts. Now, we have further subdivisions or further classification of the types of, you know, outline font. Now, the outline font can be further divided into two type of fonts. One is the, you know, you can say PostScript fonts. PostScript font. The second type is the true type fonts. And the third type, which is very commonly used nowadays, is known as open type fonts. Okay. Now, coming to this PostScript font. Now, the PostScript fonts actually, what is PostScript? I will give you a detailed lecture only on PostScript, because PostScript is very important area in digital prepress. So, unless and until we develop a basic working understanding of PostScript, we will not be able to go to the next, that is the ripping part and all of those parts. So, depending on that, I will give you a very detailed analysis of what PostScript is. So, at this stage, I am not delving deep into what PostScript is. So, at this stage, let us understand that PostScript is nothing but an interpreter based programming language. So, I hope you know what a computer programming language is. For example, C, C++, Java. These are all programming languages, right? Python, so they are programming languages. So these are all, you know, high-level programming languages. High-level meaning that human can understand. So similarly, PostScript is also a programming language, which is a very specific type of programming language. PostScript is a page description language, okay? Or PDL in short. Now, I'm not going into the depth and in-depth analysis of what is page description language or how PostScript works. We'll come to that at a later stage in a later lecture. But ultimately, PostScript, at this stage, it is sufficient for you to know that PostScript is basically a computer language. And obviously, when a font is developed using some mathematical formulations, you need a computer-based language to develop those fonts. So PostScript fonts are actually exactly that. They are basically, PostScript fonts are developed based on the PostScript language. Okay, this was developed by Adobe Systems for, you know, digital typesetting. So for DTP operations, for layout operations, for digital other professional digital typesetting operations, for all that. Now, now let us talk a little bit about what the PostScript fonts are. So, we have already mentioned that all these three types of fonts are basically classification of outline font, right? So, PostScript fonts are also type of outline font. It is not a bitmap font, obviously. PostScript fonts are also a type of outline font. So, definitely they will be using some mathematical equations, that is, they will be using some Bezier curves, right? So, that is exactly what they are doing. Now, by using the PostScript language, the fonts that are developed using the PostScript fonts that are developed, they are using a cubic Bezier curve. Okay, so I hope you know what a cubic equation is, although they are not as simple as that. So a cubic equation is maybe as simple as this, right? Now, this is what a cubic equation looks like. But for our intent and purpose, we have to take a closer look at what this type of, you know, fonts really are. And let us now analyze the type of different Bezier curves that are implemented while the development of this PostScript outline fonts really are. So let us take a look at this. Okay.